We're talking already about next year's big conference. It's going to be in Berlin, and it's going to be the ECCO 15, ESMO 34 Cancer Congress. Now, we've got the stars here to tell you about it, to tell you why you should put it in your diary already.
I think what's important is that we now really have a joint venture that will lead to phenomenal further expansion and concentration of our efforts in a way that I think critical mass of the ECCO-ESMO meeting will be such that indeed, also at a very convenient location, Berlin being a very big city and very close to New Europe and easy to get to and actually a cheap place to stay, will launch the ECCO-ESMO venture in a way that multidisciplinarity in Europe will be served by it. We will, for the first time, have a patient track integrated throughout the Congress, a patient track and an oncopolicy track.
We also would like to attract the best abstracts, and in particularly the work being done in Europe, phase three, new trials, new ideas. We would like them to be presented for the first time at ECCO ESMO Berlin. In some areas, we are clearly world leaders when it comes to innovative trial designs, when it comes to large phase three practice-changing clinical trials in several disciplines. The idea would be to increasingly attract these presentations to our European meeting. And we're going to facilitate that.
We'll come back to you in a minute. You two guys, Chris and Fortunato, what are you hoping for? What do you reckon are going to be the headlines?
We have a number of important areas. The potential role of bevacizumab and other VEGF-targeted agents, where we've seen benefits in the metastatic setting. We're eagerly awaiting the results in patients in the adjuvant setting. So those sort of trials which are going to change hopefully change the course of disease, but also change the course of how we manage patients. Those are the things that we want to see for the first time in Berlin.
The meeting is really a multidisciplinary meeting where all the disciplines of people working in cancer, from basic research to patient care, are involved. And as Chris was saying, we don't want to have separate tracks. And so the radiobiologists will follow radiobiology, radiation therapy, the nurse. What we really are trying to do is, for the first time in Europe, to have a very large meeting where everyone that works in cancer and works with patients, including the patients that are involved in the program from the first to the last day, are part of the same meeting, and they can talk and they can interact with each other. And this is very important for the young generation people and from people from Eastern Europe, for example, because what we would like to provide is a forum for the young scientists to come for the first time to present their data.
But it is ambitious, isn't
it? Yeah, it's very, very ambitious.
I mean, at most meetings you go to, you pay lip service to multidisciplinarity. Yeah. As you say, the nurses are in one corner, the patients are the day before or the day after, and the breast people are on one level, and the breast radiation therapists are another level, and so on. How are you going to do that? I mean, are you master planning it from Naples and from Leeds?
We would like to attract the best science, basic and translational and clinical science that is made in Europe and should be presented in Europe for the first time. So we would like just to gain the pride of being Europeans.
Targeted therapy. Targeted therapy. All the rage.
We are talking about phase one, phase two, and phase three studies today. This is going to be gone. I mean, we'll see in Berlin studies that we will not know how to call them. Study 0, 0A, 1A, you name it. Actually, one session that we could organize would be a session on studies we don't know how to call. this is probably one of the most exciting sessions that we could have. I'd love to share that one. But this is what's happening. One discipline will not cut it. You need to understand, if you do a window study without talking to the surgical colleagues, you're going to fail. You will not be able to identify the time to do surgery, and the time of or the type of surgery that will be done may not be appropriate. And this is just one example, and things go on and go on. So this level of complexity, which is good for the system and is good for our advances, will require a new set of skills for all of us.
Quite a challenge. So next year, ECCO 15, ESMO 34 in Berlin is going to be a revolutionary meeting.